as religion is losing its foot in the European psyche, what develops out of that really is what Nietzsche termed nihilism, or a void, really. And what Nietzsche said is, once we eliminate God as an absolute value from the picture, all other values automatically disappear, you see. Because if I don't believe in a hisab, in an account, in a reckoning, if I don't believe that there's a moral authority outside of myself that imposes upon me moral imperatives, then really nobody can impose anything upon me. If there's nothing absolute, if things are relative in their nature, then nothing can, nobody can tell me what to do or what to say. If, for instance, as a humanist, I choose not to kill, this is a hypothetical imperative. I choose not to kill. Somebody else down the road can say, I choose to kill. Right? And this happens. Why did you kill him? Well, it was Monday. I don't like Monday. Somebody actually said that. They killed something. Somebody went and shot a bunch of children in California, I think. And they asked them why they did it. Well, it was Monday. I don't like Mondays. You see, and that is really neat. I mean, you're getting into deep nihilism there, where there's nothing there. It's just a void. So if I've watched The Predator 50 times, which I think that person did, I haven't seen it one time, but I'm supposing it's some gruesome movie about a guy that goes around shooting people and kind of feeling good about it, right? And so this person had watched this program 50 times or something and then went out and did it, right? And then people say, well, there's no scientific evidence that watching television has any effect on the behavior of people. We've done several studies and there's no proof, right?